watching News 8.
I'm pleased to welcome Dr. Anthony Petralia from Rochester Regional Health back to the program. Doctor, great to see you. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
Our topic is an important one. We're about midway through August here, and certainly the summer temperatures continue to bump up. We're talking about heat stroke, sort of the spectrum of what that means and what folks should be thinking about. Let's begin by defining it and the different ways that it presents.
Sure. Really, heat stroke is you know, an issue that is on the spectrum of heat illness and can occur when one's body temperature raises to dangerous levels. And certainly a little bit of a difference from, you know, traditional or classic heat stroke that happens in elderly folks or a heat wave comes through. This is exertional heat stroke when athletes or military personnel or construction workers are out in the heat and their body temperatures raise to dangerous levels, causing a variety of symptoms.
What are we looking for, either in ourselves or perhaps in somebody else? What are the signs?
You know, the symptoms can be as benign as heat cramps and muscle aches, but again, can span that spectrum along the lines of heat exhaustion and then go on to be heat stroke. So, you know, certainly having a high index of suspicion for symptoms that can range from nausea, vomiting, dizziness, but also speech changes and mood and personality changes, somebody becoming irritable or aggressive or even withdrawn. And the classic presentation of seeing somebody that's got dry, you know, sort of high temperature, hot skin, dry skin, it's not typically seen. I mean, we can see, frankly, more often than not, people with, you know, profuse sweating.
Mm. What do we do if we recognize any of these signs?
Well, it's quite an emergency, and it's one where you want to act quickly, and the key is to get them into a cool environment. You want to drop their body temperature if possible, a cold ice bath. Cold cloths and towels. You want to drop their body temperature from what is typically around 104 degrees Fahrenheit down to around 102, and then call 911 and get them to the emergency department.
Obviously, we want to try to avoid this situation altogether. What are the preventative steps people can take, you know, before even going out into the heat?
Yeah, usually this is something that happens in a hot and humid environment. So we talk about things like, you know, wearing lighter clothing, you know, trying to get away from having the two-a-day practices, or if you're going to have two-a-day practices, doing it at the point at which the sun sets and it's cooler outside, or early first thing in the morning. We talk about wearing lighter clothing, and then, you know, making sure that athletes are acclimated to that hot temperature over a course of 7 to 14 days as you build up their tolerance. So these are the sort of things that you try to do to prevent heat stroke and heat illness in general, and again, having that high index of suspicion.
Thanks for coming in. We appreciate it. Good to see you again.
Thank you.
Information online if you want to get more on this topic. Heat stroke is the topic. Go to rochesterregional.org. Use the search tab there and just type in heat stroke. It'll bring up lots of information for you there. If you missed any of this, including that link, we're sharing it online at rochesterfirst.com.